This is a default proximity prompt. It has this user interface as all of you know. First, we need to disable this. Change the style property of the proximity prompt to custom from default. This will remove the UI. This prompt will still work without an user interface, but we want an user interface. This prompt's user interface will be handled by a script. Start by creating a local script in Starter Player Scripts folder. It is in Starter Player folder. This will handle the user interface of these proximity prompts with using their events, specially prompt shown and prompt hidden. If you just want to modify the default one, you will need to copy something from Roblox Creator Documentation website. This page will be linked in the description. Copy this from one of these code samples here with this small copy icon. Paste the script you copied to this local script you have created. This is basically what handles a default proximity prompt. These are the user interface codes for them. You can change anything you want from here basically. You can replace the icons, make a background frame, or whatever else is possible. I will show the non-changed version of this script first. As seen from the game preview, this is exactly the same as the default one and touch controls still work. As I said, you can change anything you want from here, but I will just change the frame background color for showing you how this works. This is a standard frame, so you can just set a new property, or change an existing one from here. Now let's see how this looks in game. This is how it looks with red background. You can still have default looking proximity prompts while having these. If a proximity prompt has its style property as default, this script won't change its user interface, which means you can mix them in your games. This event is what controls all these. By default, it uses proximity prompt service. With this service, you can connect events or set properties which will affect every single proximity prompt in the game. If you want to have different styles in your game, you will need to replace some stuff from this script. I recommend using collection service for this, which I already made a video for. You can check what got added and add an event depending on the object. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.